Want to know how you can avoid entering a flood zone beforehand? With the pilot flood forecasting system launched by the Public Utilities Board, or PUB, Singaporeans and businesses will be given advance warning to avoid flood-prone areas. The system is expected to be rolled out within 2 years.
We are trying to build a pilot flood forecasting system. What we're trying to do is to link our key sensors of the weather radar, our rain gauges, our water level sensors, and then plugging it to our model in order to provide some level of forecast in specific areas ahead of time. I think if we are able to forecast by minutes, that will already help in terms of helping the general public to take necessary preparations to avoid the flood area. And this is something that we can certainly help the public to actually improve the ability to actually mitigate impact of floods. Now, I have to say that this is actually a pilot system. We are only in beginning to build such a system, and we will have to obviously recognize there are limitations in terms of the accuracy of the forecast in the beginning.
To further enhance the warning system on flood situations around the island, images from selected CCTVs will be made available to the public through PUB's website by March 2012. This announcement came in conjunction with PUB's acceptance of the flood panel's recommendations. Over the next 5 years, at least $750 million will be spent on 20 drain improvement projects. Among these, the capacity of 6 major canals, including the Bukit Timah Diversion Canal, Rochow Canal, and Geylang River Canal, will be increased by between 30 to 45%. Specifically for the Stamford Canal, which runs under the Orchard Road Belt and whose limited capacity has been cited as a cause of the Orchard Road floods, National Water Agency, PUB, will remove a sewer and new water pipelines which are currently running within the canal.
We are taking immediate measures to see how we can further squeeze and maximise the capacity of Stamford Canal without actually expanding the size of the canal. We are looking at smoothing the surface of the canal in order to reduce friction, as well as removing some of the services that are within the canal. The idea here is actually to maximize the canal capacity by up to about 10% within the next 9 to 12 months. And certainly that will help in terms of flood elevation within the area.
These short-term measures hope to increase the flow capacity of the Stamford Canal. However, there are also long-term solutions, which include constructing retention ponds, like the one under a school field along Opera Road, and more diversion canals to reduce surface runoff from entering major canals. In light of increasing weather uncertainties and urbanisation, PUB will review its drainage master plan once every 3 instead of 5 years, and it will be made public with effect from 2013. In the next clip, we find out more about major canal improvements.